Hey, today I want to show you my new computer for photo and video editing because my old system with the Intel i5 4670 CPU and the GeForce GTX 750 graphics card was not fast enough for video editing in 4K. That's why I chose for the new system the components myself. They have a value of around 800 euros. But the SSD and the graphics card I can maybe reuse from my old system. What's important for a video editing PC? The requirements are different to a gaming PC. For a gaming PC, it's most important to have a good graphics card, but for video editing, the CPU is most important. That's why I chose a strong CPU. Then for me, it's also important that the system is as silent as possible because maybe I want to make a video while sitting at the in front of the computer, and then I don't want to record the sound of the computer as well. Then it's important to have enough memory. I think 16 gigabytes are the minimum for photo and video editing. It's important that the operating system and the graphics programs load as fast as possible. That's why I also have the SSDs. And then maybe from time to time I want to play a small game. I will show you the components one by one and explain why I chose them. This is the case. It's a Fractal Design Define C. It's a good looking, compact and silent case. It already has two fans included. I was thinking for some time to buy the version with a window because it's nice to see what's happening inside the PC, but I decided to go for the version with a solid side panel because it's better to have less noise because of that. One disadvantage of this case and of all new cases is that you cannot put the internal card reader into the case because the front is meant to put up to three fans. But it's not a big problem because you can always use the USB 3 plugins to put an external card reader to read your photos and videos. This is maybe the best CPU right now, the Intel Core i7 CPU, after the beginning of the year when AMD had the lead with the Ryzen system. This version of the CPU can be overclocked. It's the i7-8700K, but I will see how it works with my CPU cooling solution and my case fans. This is my CPU cooling solution. It's the PureRock Slim from BeQuiet. It's a very cheap cooler and it's also very silent. This is what I wanted. And this has 120 watts of cooling. This should be enough to cool down the CPU and maybe I can even overclock it a little bit. But I didn't want to spend too much money to start with. This is the main board. It's a ASRock Z370 Extreme 4. I chose it because it has many USB connections, which is nice for photo editing. And also it has the option to put M.2 SSDs on the board. And if I put operating system and graphic programs on these SSDs, they will start even faster. This is my power adapter. It's a straight power, 600 watts from BeQuiet. It's 80 plus gold certificated for the efficiency. Then it's a modular power adapter. That means I can plug in the cables or plug them out as I need. They're not fixed. Maybe it's overkill for my components, but I wanted to have some playroom for the future. And also I want to have a silent power adapter. This is the RAM. It's the Aegis 3000 DDR4 RAM from Gskill, 2 x 8 GB. I chose the cheapest RAM, the cheapest fast RAM that was available. And 16 gigabytes should be enough. And if I want, I can put 2 more 8 GB. Memory is very expensive at the moment, unfortunately. I will turn on the PC now. As you can see, it's working very well. I can edit videos now in 4K without a problem. Of course, the computer is not completely silent, but this was not to be expected, but it's much quieter than my old PC. Next, I want to try to overclock the computer, but I think it will be maybe difficult because of my cooling solution. Maybe I have to buy a fan from Noctua, a bigger fan, which is also silent. But you cannot have a completely silent setup and many fans which are required for overclocking. Anyways, I will write about my results of the overclocking below the video. I hope my video was useful for you. If so, please like my video and subscribe to my channel. If you have any question, don't hesitate to post it below. Thank you. See you next time. Bye.